What do you think are the biggest obstacles for Indonesians to create blockbuster IPs like Final Fantasy, Metal Gear Solid, Disney, Sonic, Mario, etc.? Is it lack of money, imagination, market readiness, or what do you think? The next question for Steven.
Yeah.
How can we or brands humanize their content through movies or films?
I think it's as simple as by talking like a human gitu through a content. We should think about the objective. We should understand who's your target audience, and always yang ini yang selalu menjadi sebuah tantangan, challenges for us. Kita kan selalu mikir, oh ya, gimana kita punya konten atau kita punya video bisa di accept in the market. Tapi kadang kita lupa bahwa actually how we can do that is as if we're talking to one person aja. As if kayak gua mau cerita ke lu, tapi we know that you are representing a lot of people, and it will be easier for us to humanize the content itself.
Boleh kasih example nggak?
Yeah, example is as simple as kayak kita sama bikin waktu kita bikin sama I think one of the last campaign kita actually baru shooting lagi sama HP. Mereka mau introduce their new product, which is a laptop gaming laptop gitu kan. Terus kita udah bikinin cerita dan segala macam, dan kita kasih waktu itu kita kasih talent yang menurut kita baik, jauh lebih terkenal, Instagram followersnya tinggi dan segala macam. Actually this became a learning for our team juga. Terus si kliennya ngomong, oh actually we don't really care lu punya talent sejago apa, seterkenal apa. Tapi apakah si talent itu relatable tidak terhadap target audience mereka, which is gamer. Nah itu yang kita akhirnya, oh okay. Kita akhirnya cari talent yang actually juga gamer, yang talent yang mana diidam-idamkan oleh para gamer. So it will be easier to communicate the content.
Mungkin juga yang pernah lo kasih tau juga ya, apa yang interactive videos with one of the telco company, mungkin yang about family atau apa, yang gue lupa temanya, tapi yang bisa pilih actionnya kan, karena itu apa yang interactive video ya.
Yeah. Kalau itu kita pernah sama Telkomsel kita bikin film buat mereka interaktif, buat actually is for their OTT, is about cinta, and I think this is one of also a easy sweet spot to make content or to convey ini in a humanized content is about romance basically, dengan cerita cinta. Waktu itu kita menggunakan artis-artisnya juga yang relatable, dan actually mereka dulu pernah pacaran, itu chemistry-nya jauh lebih dapet juga, dan di ceritanya pun kita juga banyak choices yang mana unpredictable, dan di situ karena of this unpredictable factor, a lot of the users mereka ngulang lagi the same episode, watch it from the beginning untuk nonton lagi sampai habis, and mereka bilang one of the data shows mereka punya time span jadi naik, dan actually it became one of the best performing original series juga.
Okay, thank you. So last question I think is from Arya.
Okay, in the last question. Jadi tiap kali ada founders dari webinar kita selalu tanya last question ini. What are the key takeaways of being a founder that you have learned from your journey. Jadi kayak misalnya apa aja yang bisa bisa di share kepada aspiring founders or entrepreneurs, mungkin bisa one key point or two key points or anything or any specific feedback yang or advice that you can give. Let's start with Stephen first.
I think waktu Arya mulai this podcast or this webinar, interesting waktu dia mention sometimes it became lonely as a founder. Kadang kan kalau kita in a team, yes, if we have a co-founder, kita bisa tukar pikiran, tapi kan cuma sama satu dua orang, dan terkadang kita juga nggak bisa ngomong banyak hal terhadap employee dan segala macam. Yang mana, let's say you are in a bad condition, you obviously cannot share this to your employee. But dengan itu, it's dengan ada community seperti ini, punya teman-teman kayak Rocky yang very supportive and everything, it makes us became more sane. And waktu kita share our problem to them, ternyata they also sometimes facing the same problem. Dan itu kayak bikin kita lebih tenang. Oh, ternyata nggak cuma gue sendiri sih sebenarnya, di luar sana everyone also facing. Yeah, I think one of the best thing is actually to enjoy the ride. Karena kalau misalnya you can't enjoy it, you will be so stressful. Especially in a startup, today you like a roller coaster kan, sehari lagi naik, oh happy, besoknya oh shit gitu. So I think enjoying it, the process is also very important.
Tapi kalau tadi lu bilang bahwa ada downtime-nya gitu ya, berarti yeah, enjoy the ride, but when you're down, don't forget to reach out, right?
True.
Karena kalau lagi lonely, kalau nggak reach out ke orang lain, itu yang bakal bikin jadi depression kan?
Yeah.
So I think don't forget to reach out is probably also important.
Yes.
Definitely, yeah.
Okay. Thank you, Steven. Okay, Rocky, how about you?
Yeah, to echo that, yeah, definitely. Support system itu penting banget ya. Dan yeah, I would say my tips to fellow founders is to have your goal, right? When you are going for your goal, you will encounter problems. It's always a cycle of you have a goal that you want to reach, and along the way you will encounter problem, and how you react to that and overcome and reach out to your support system, knowing you're not alone, come back and overcome that problem until you can find a resolution. That's definitely, if I may say, universal story of founders, gitu kan? Or many, many people. Gitu, okay? And so after that, then you can go for your next goal and your next, you will encounter problem again. And so this whole cycle can continue. And I believe that's life, right? It's exciting in that way. And over time, you will encounter more and more challenging problems as you reach for higher and higher goals. And so, and of course, along the way, you know, it's definitely very important to have the right mentors, the right partners, you know, your backers, your friends to support each other and make this a meaningful life.
don't forget family.
Oh, yeah. I forgot that. My wife will kill me. Yeah.
Be nice to everyone because you never know who's gonna help you. Yes, I think that's important.
Of course. Always be kind and nice, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you, Rocky. Thank you, Steven. Let Adi have the closing. Thank you.
So thank you, Rocky and Steven. We're hoping for your collaboration, maybe creating a movie out of the game.
For sure.
Warung Chain, right? Warung Chain the movie.
Warung Chain the movie, yeah. Tado TV the game, right?
Okay, so thank you again to both of you. We will send follow-up email for feedback form and AWS application form to the participants who register through Goers. If there is any more question, participants can fill in form in the follow-up email. And thank you for all the partners for today's session. Stay tuned to CR.com and CR News YouTube channel for recording of the events. You can also find us at Dengarkan podcast platform for iOS and Android. So next episode is on Monday, August 10th, 2020, same time. And for the speakers, it will be determined later. So thank you, everyone. Thank you, speakers. See you next time.
Thank you.